Hello guys and welcome to my YouTube channel. If you are looking for an ultimate telescope with a GoTo mount which can track the objects as well as find the objects in the night sky, here I have with me Celestron NexStar 127 SLT. We are going to do an unboxing for this. So if you are new to my channel and not yet subscribed to my channel, please hit that subscribe button and click that bell icon to get the notifications for all my new videos. Let's get started. So guys, let's start with the unboxing. As you can see, whenever the Celestron NexStar 127 SLT is delivered, it is delivered into a huge box. This box is a heavyweight box. The gross weight of this box is around 13.8 kgs and the net weight of the box is 8.8 kg. As you can see on the box, you have the Celestron logo and some markings which tells you what is the type of telescope inside. So the telescope inside obviously is Celestron NexStar 127 SLT. So now since we have opened the first box, the upper covering, let's see what is there inside. Once you open the main box, the upper covering, you will see there is another packing which is covering another box which is present inside. On the printed box, you can see the Celestron logo and the name of the telescope, which is NexStar 127 SLT, along with some of the instructions and guidelines which are essential. If you want, you can go through these instructions and guidelines. Now let's open the upper covering as well. You have to be very careful. You need to ensure that the telescope is in the right direction. You can see the arrows which are clearly marked. So this should be the section which is on the top, which has to be on the top. So you have to be very gentle. This is a long box and this is a sliding box cover that you need to take it out. If you need some help from your other family members, please do take that help because this box is really heavy. So this is the third box in the row that we have to open to reach out to the main component. So carefully and gently open the last box. Inside this box will be the main components of the telescope. So let's open the box and see what is inside. The last box is opened. This is what you see, how components are properly organized inside the main box. Now let us see one by one each thing. So this is some of the document that comes along with this telescope. If you want, you can go through it along with the CD and other software. So this is the first box. Let's open and see what is inside this first box. Inside the box, as you can see, everything is nicely packed in the bubble wrap. So first thing that you can see is the Celestron NexStar Plus controller. Let's keep that aside. Next thing that you can see is the base plate that is used on the tripod. Here is the Phillips screwdriver that comes along with the telescope for the maintenance. So the next thing that you can see is the laser red dot finder. Next thing in the row is the 90 degree mirror diagonal. This is the 9mm eyepiece that comes along with it. This is the second eyepiece that comes along with it, is a 25mm eyepiece. So this is it, what was there in the box. So now let us see what is next inside. So this is the largest thing and the heaviest thing inside this Celestron box, is the mount along with the guiding module. It is pre-assembled from the factory, so you don't have to assemble it here. So be gentle and careful. This is one of the heaviest components that is present inside the box. Next thing that you can see inside the box is the main component, which is the telescope itself. So let's open this box and see what is inside. So this is one of the heaviest component as well. So you have to be very gentle and be careful while opening this telescope. This telescope is very heavy, so take good care while opening this telescope. This telescope is a Maksutov-Cassegrain design. Its aperture is around 127 mm with focal length of around 1500 with focal ratio of f/12. So maximum magnification given by this telescope is around 300x or 300 times magnification, and the lowest magnification that it can give is around 18 times. as you can see, it has a large aperture, so it has a high light gathering power as well. So it can gather around 329 times more light as compared to normal human eye. Since it can gather large amount of light, it can capture very faint object in the deep space and also make things like planets and other celestial objects little more brighter and clearer. It comes with a focusing knob at the back for focusing the telescope, which moves the main mirror inside to get the right focus. And it also comes with the dust cap to protect the front glass. So this is it. So let's move on to the next thing. So this is mirror right angle diagonal that comes along with this telescope. This is 1.25 inch compatible right angle diagonal. It is a mirror diagonal, so it erects the image from top to bottom and left to right. So this is used in the telescope for comfortable viewing from the top. Now let's move on to the next thing. Next thing in the list is the red dot finder, which is to be mounted on the telescope itself. This is laser red dot finder, which is used by the telescope to locate the object. We first have to align this red dot finder to a distant object and then align the telescope along with it so that we can find the objects comfortably in the night sky. Next thing that we're gonna open is the eyepiece. This is the Celestron 9mm eyepiece. As you know, 9mm is the focal length of the eyepiece. Lower the focal length, higher the magnification. So this 9mm eyepiece provides 167 times magnification to this telescope. So the second eyepiece that comes along with this is 25mm eyepiece. This is higher focal length. As you know, higher the focal length, lesser the magnification. So this 25mm eyepiece provides magnification of around 60 times. Next thing that we are going to see is the accessory tray. This is the tray that comes along with this Celestron NexStar telescope. This is mounted on the tripod. This provides not just the stability to the tripod, duals the role of holding the accessories that you use along with this telescope. Next thing is the Phillips screwdriver. This is the Star Phillips screwdriver that comes along with this NexStar telescope. This is used for maintenance and repair of this telescope. Next thing we're gonna see is the hand controller. This is Celestron NexStar Plus hand controller. This is the newest version of this controller. This is used for controlling your mount and locating the objects. As you can see at the bottom of this controller, you have the new port, which is mini USB port, which is used for remote controlling or updating the controller. Now let us have a look at the computerized GoTo mount. This is the tripod that comes along with the GoTo mount. On the side, you see the aux port and the hand control port. Aux port is used to connect the accessories and hand control port to the hand controller. On the side, you will see the on-off switch. This is the tripod legs. As you can see on the top, you have a Celestron logo which holds the batteries to power the mount. On the top, you see the dovetail holder which holds the telescope itself. At the bottom, you can see there is a knob which holds this GoTo mount on this tripod steadily. Now let's assemble this tripod quickly. Expand the tripod legs so that the three wedges are tightened. Now take your telescope. There is a dovetail at the bottom, as you can see. So this dovetail will go in this fork mount. This is the dovetail holder on the GoTo mount. Hold your telescope gently and gently slide it onto this fork mount holder. Tighten the screw at the bottom to secure your telescope. Ensure that it is tight enough to hold the weight of the telescope. Next thing you need to attach is the hand controller. Using this wire, there is a hand controller port on this GoTo mount on which you connect your hand controller. To securely hold this hand controller, you have a hand controller holder on one of the leg of this GoTo mount. All you have to do is slide your hand controller onto that slot, and it will hold your hand controller securely. Next thing you need to attach is the star diagonal, that 90 degree mirror diagonal that comes along with it. First thing is to remove the cap of the eyepiece on the telescope, and then also remove the caps of this 90 degree diagonal and loosen the screw both on the star diagonal as well as on the eyepiece of the telescope. This silver side will go inside this eyepiece of the telescope. Ensure that you loosen the screw and slide it gently inside the eyepiece, and then tighten back the screw to hold this diagonal securely. Next thing you need to do is put your eyepiece. This is 25mm eyepiece. Remove the dust cap and the bottom cap from the eyepiece. And since you have already loosened the screw on the star diagonal, this eyepiece will slide directly into it, and then you need to secure it by tightening the screw. Now, since you have attached the eyepiece, now let us attach the accessory tray. As you can see, the slots are cut inside the accessory tray. You need to align the slot on the base and rotate it slightly. This will secure your tripod, and it will also dual the role for holding the accessories that you use along with the telescope. Now, next thing that we're going to attach is the laser red dot finder. As you can see, there is a plastic attached on the front side of it. This plastic is an insulation between the battery and this red dot finder. Unless you remove this, this red dot finder is not going to work. So once you remove this, you have to move the second circle on the back, which has the white dot, which will turn on the red dot finder, and you'll be able to see the red dot from this view scope. So this red dot finder is to be securely attached on this slot. As you can see, you have to slide it from the bottom up and then tighten the screw on the right side. As you can see, you have to slide from the bottom up and then tighten the screw to hold this red dot finder securely on this telescope. Once the red dot finder is attached, your telescope is ready for celestial viewing. So this concludes the unboxing and assembly of Celestron NexStar 127 SLT telescope. I hope you like this video. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the comment sections. I will try and answer as soon as possible. If you like this video, please hit that like button. If you are not yet subscribed to my channel, hit that subscribe button and click that bell icon to get the notifications for all my new videos.